Hello, Mary! Salutations, everyone! Squid here, bringing you the first battle of the YCL Season 3. And I apologize in advance for the volume of this audio recording. I have to talk a little bit... Quieter. More quiet. Yeah. I have to talk a little bit more quiet than usual because I have people already sleeping in my house. It's almost midnight, quarter to midnight, and I'm going to face off against Southside Braves, a very good friend of mine. I have battled against him before. I believe we are 1-1 in battling records, if I'm not mistaken. Not quite sure. But it's always a pleasure battling against Adam. He's a really good friend, a really cool dude. He helped me make the first part of the power rankings last season, and I deeply appreciate him for that. And so let's see the team that he drafted for this season. And it's this one. It's kind of a mix between a sand team and a sand team. So it's two weather team. With the Dapfufini leading the charge, that Diancie will also be troublesome, especially if it's in the sand. Talking about the things that he does lack, he's quite lacking on water switchings, and we're gonna exploit that to the maximum with our team this week. And yeah, so let's show up what we cooked up. So I'm bringing Caesar against a Sun team. That might be stupid, but Caesar is actually my best switching into the Weavile, so that's what I'm counting on the Caesar for, because the Rocky Helmet should chip the Weavile quite a lot, especially if it locks himself into Triple Axel or something like that. Even with Knockoff, the chip from the Rocky Helmet is pretty good. And with the Technician boosted Bullet Punch, I basically OKO it back, so that's a nice thing to have. And I think the only way he has to hit KO my Caesar with this spread is basically have clicking Triple Axel twice and not missing a single one of them. And that's quite hard to do, so I'm not expecting that to happen. Hence this Caesar set, which should work really nicely against switching in on the Weavile. U-turn for momentum, roost to get my health back, to still be able to switch in multiple times on the Weavile, and the defog in case I need to get rid of the rocks that probably the Hippowdon will set them up. And to deal with the Apaldon, the first thing we have is the Kabutops. Oh, by the way, forgot to mention. Nicknames for this week are from natural disasters. So we have Asteroid here, and now we have Flood, as in Diluvium. So, Swift Swim. Let's talk about Swift Swim. Swift Swim is an ability that's double speed in the rain. And spoilers, I did bring rain. Not in 1 month, but in 2 months. Because there's no weather like manual weather, and we're gonna try to exploit that to the maximum this week. So, water poison coverage against this team is basically unresisted, so we bring both the cross poison and the liquidation. Cross poison is actually a suggestion by Bishmi, because I hadn't noticed that Kabutops got the cross poison. Liquidation in the rain will hurt anything that switches in or that stays on the field. Knockoff to potentially knock off Tapu Fini switching in on the first time, and Aqua Jet in case I need to revenge kill the Weavile or something fast like the Charizard and have no other tools available to do that. Choice Band to maximize our damage output, and this is basically it for the Kabutops. We'll go next into Radiation, the Drapion, and we have a Sniper Scope Lens set here. And the idea for the Scope Lens is to get 50% crit chance on the Cross Poison, and I'm kind of scared of a setup Tapu Fini with Iron Defense and Calm Mind, and this way the Cross Poison should guarantee that I will chew through the setup Tapu Fini pretty easily. Aquatel to make that water poison coverage that is really good against his team. Toxic Spikes against the Tapu Fini may seem weird, but my logic behind it is that I can set up the Toxic Spikes even when the terrain is up, and then eventually when the terrain disappears, things will start to get poisoned, and he may forget that he still has the Toxic Spikes on his side of the field, and maybe something gets poisoned. I don't know. I might not even click them, I'm not sure yet, so we'll see in the heat of the moment if I click them or not. Next up we have the Heliolisk Drought. We have the Dry Skin, and we want to make use of the Dry Skin to potentially switch in on the Tapu Fini, and we do have our first Rain Setter this week. We have Rain Dance, we have Hold Switch, we have Surf to hit that pesky Hippowdon, and we have Magnet Rise to stay in on the Hippowdon, because I don't have pretty good switch-ins into ground, so I really need a good ground switching, and Magnet Rise may bait his Hippowdon into staying in, and then I can basically get free damage on something. And I can set up the rain pretty safely, even if I expect the Hippowdon switching, because I know that I can survive the... I can magnetize the next turn to survive the incoming Earthquake. And this is basically it. We'll go now into Earthquake, the Flygon. And Flygon is here as the third priority on our team, because that first impression will do a number on the Weavile, so we have that. We have enough speed to speed tie with the Charizard. Thunder Punch hits it back, U-turn for momentum, and Earthquake hits pretty much a good chunk of his team, so it's nice step to have this week. No need for the dragon move with a double fairy on his team, so we didn't bring it. And Expert Belt to hit stuff more hard, I don't know. We'll go into Volcano now, the Volcanion. Original nickname, I know. We do have to have that Water Absorb because it's our only ability. And Modest, special, Modest 252 Special Attack EVs. Steam Eruption and Sludge Wave will deal a number on his team. He doesn't switch in on this at all. And Defog to defog the hazards away, of course. And Rain Dance, because it's our second Rain Setter on this week. I'll probably lead with the Volcanion. I'm still not sure, but I'll probably do it. Either Volcanion or Heliolisk, one of the two, will be my lead. And yeah, guys, this is basically it. Braves should be ready in a few, and I'll catch you guys on the battle. See ya. It's on, guys. That Machoke, I was not expecting that at all. But I guess it kind of makes sense to not make his team super weak to water attacks or something like that. No Tapu Fini. That's amazing. That's really amazing. I might lead with Drapion just because of that. Because his way to remove rocks... it's actually... But do I want to get boost the Machoke? Maybe not. Tell you what, I'll lead with this. I'll lead with this. I'm expecting either a Torkoal lead or something. The priority that Machoke has is basically Bullet Punch. I don't think Bullet Punch will KO the Heliolisk from full. So basically that's it. Yeah, it's on, guys. The start of the season is here. Good luck, have fun to my good buddy Southside Braves. Let's see if this is a good one. We're playing on away fields, so we already have the disadvantage. The game already trying to make us lose. And here is the Machoke, right off the bat. What do I have to hit this thing? I don't think I have anything. This might be a problem. Indeed. Maybe I'll go for Volcanion and just try to hit it as hard as possible. Okay, that's some nice chunk actually. Didn't think I would do as much. I think my most expendable member is actually the Drapion. Yeah, I'll go Drapion and try to knock off the Eviolite or something like that. He might go knock off himself. Ice Punch. Okay. I can't. I just can't. Of course, he makes the prediction. It's not a prediction, actually. Just had to click the super effective move. Squid, you idiot. But I should be faster. Ooh, this animation is pretty cool. Okay, got one down, guys. Not a 6-0 on his side. It might still be on my our side. So well, the good thing about the Drapion being frozen is that I now get a free sack, I think. So, if I were him, I would go Charizard because it outspeeds the Volcanion. Or maybe the Hippowdon if it's like Pashu Berry. Okay, Sand Stream. We'll do this. We'll go Drapion. And we're basically gonna sack it. Because I don't want Volcanion to be KO'd at this point of the match. And he's trying to predict the Flygon coming in. Still not working. Let's knock off, because I don't want this thing being Pashu Berry. Of course I'm Frozen Solid. Okay. We're done. So, we're going to Heliolisk. We're gonna Magnetrise. It's probably thinking, who the hell switches in Heliolisk on the Hippowdon? Who's this? Ooh, Torkoal. Nice. It's time to bring out the tech. It's okay. No problem. We have the Rain Dance. Yeah, Braves. Now what do you do? It's raining, man. It's raining rain, I guess. Okay. Hmm. It's making me sleepy. Not ideal. Jan wasn't on the plans, not gonna lie. We have to do this. And he basically won the momentum back. Self-rock, okay. We're free to steam eruption now. Or do I want to default? No, I want to steam eruption because that basically guarantees that the Hippowdon can't. That I can KO the Hippowdon. He basically has to sack something now. If he wants to KO me then with the Hippowdon. Okay, here he is. And what does he have? Special Berry? Yes, Special Berry. Good, we brought it. That's definitely not gonna save you. So let's do it again. If we KO this, we're basically free to Volt Switch with the Heliolisk, which is pretty nice, not gonna lie. So Heliolisk will be so much enabled now. Okay. We do have a switch into this, so there's no need to sack the Volcanion. And the scissor is coming in, and it's gonna take this attack pretty well. Whichever it is. Probably knockoff. Fake out. Ooh! Even better. Okay. Now we're basically free to U-turn. Okay, a little bit of chip damage on this thing is really good. Now I feel like we go into the into this and we just Earthquake. The Earthquake? Yeah, maybe we U-turn. Because he already has the rocks up, right? Stealth Rock. I don't have rocks up. Yeah, I feel like he will go into Charizard here expecting the Earthquake or something like that. He stayed in. That's definitely not ideal. But oh well, we'll have to make do with it. What wants to take a hit from this? He won't go for the... He won't definitely go for the Earth Power, so I think... I feel like we should tank whatever he does with the Kabutops. Yawn. I can't let Kabutops go to sleep. I have to do this back again. He withdrew into what? Cardinal should be the Diancie. Okay. Fancy Diancie. So Diamond Storm is a thing. Pretty nasty thing. Let's go into this. Feel like we should be able to tank it. Moonblast. Yeah, we tank this even better. Now we roost to heal back up this damage. Bullet punch is not enough to kill, but it would deal a pretty good chunk, so I don't think he would stay in. Yes, thank you. Now this is the Charizard. How many turns of sun are left? Great, Charizard is already losing HP. 3. Think Volcanion has reached the end of its life expectancy. Might still be good against the Diancie though. I think I'll switch directly into Flygon. And even if he goes for the fire move, it will be deal a good chunk. Ooh, Tailwind. Oh. Oh. Still losing HP. Good. Let's Thunder Punch. He will outspeed me for sure. He should go for Hurricane now. And I basically have to stall out the Sun turns. And once he KOs the Flygon, I'll basically have to sack the... That shouldn't KO. Yes. Great. Ooh. Solar Power KOs, so it's a no KO stuff thing, whatever. He shouldn't go for Torkoal yet. He will go into Weavile. He has to go into Weavile. If he goes into Weavile, I'll go into Scissor. There's the Weavile. Okay. So let's chip this thing a little bit more. And the good thing about the Flygon is that I don't think it dies to rocks even coming in. So that's pretty nice. I just noticed that the nickname of Scissor was cut out. Okay. You knocked me out. Knocked me off. That's okay. That did deal a pretty sizable chunk. He's faked out. He's not locked in. If he's not locked in, he can go into Triple Axel and KO me. So I have to Bullet Punch now. Okay, he went into Torkoal, the same. Okay, but it's a, but it's still good. Because now... I'll roost just in case he wants to go for Yawn. Lava Plume, okay. I still have two priority users in my team, so I'm not bummed by that. What we'll do now is go into Heliolisk. Is go into Heliolisk, exactly. Could have gone into Flygon too, actually. We'll go into Heliolisk and we'll Rain Dance once again. Then we'll Volt Switch out into the Kabutops, and the Kabutops should clean house. Alright. Maybe just in case, I'll stay in and surf. Because I'm still not threatened by the Earth Power. And he may switch out thinking that he wants to reset the weather. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. We catch the Diancie on the switch. Hooray. I'll do something. I'll volt switch, and if he goes into the Weavile, I basically... Oh no, he has Fake Out. He may use that. I'm not sure. It's quite tricky, actually. What? Oh, Braves. No. Alright, we'll go into this. Yes, we'll go into this. And we'll steam eruption. Anything dies now. So he chooses the Diancie to die. I think it would be my choice too. So, thing is, he will go into Weavile now. I basically have no switching. I could switch into Flygon. Could I? Can I switch anything? Nah, I'm just sack this. Oh boy. Okay, yeah, good thing this steam eruption didn't miss. Okay, still not problematic given the priority that I have, but the sun did break the damage quite a lot. Okay, so there goes the Volcanion. Does Weavile learn Ice Shard? I don't think it does. But we're gonna learn today. He might not have Ice Shard because he's the fastest thing on the field already. First impression, let's go. Oof! Good thing about first impression, it's not affected by sun. Its damage is not affected by sun, like steam eruption was. So that's pretty nice. And the earthquake should do the trick now. Yes. Yes, guys. We start off with a win. Hooray. So, good game to Adam. This was a really fun one. That freeze on the beginning was quite fun, not gonna lie. I feel like it wouldn't be as fun if I actually lost the match because of it. But oh well, that's Pokemon for you. In a nutshell, thank you once again to Adam for the amazing battle. We start off in the right foot on this league, guys. Now, let's forget about the 04 thing that happened in the UBA, shall we? I'd like to say that in future matches I hope that I can be a little bit more energetic with my speech, because I really do have to contain my volume right now. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave a like on the video, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys on the next one.
Squid.